Hi guys, and welcome to another video. In the last episode, we set up this little farm here, and now I have it working a little bit better. I like this setup. So between last episode and this episode, I wanted to just go over a few things that I did. First off, I filled out this farm completely, and it took forever, but I upgraded all of these seeds to tier 6. They're all tier 6 seeds now. So that took quite a lot of water canning, and it also took like 10,000 of this essence. I didn't realize it was going to take so much. Let's go ahead and head down here really quickly. I'll show you this as well. So this is all the essence I have left. This was completely full, and I don't know what the max is. So we've gotten it up a little bit, because actually farming this at tier 6 gives you a ton back. But yeah, so this is tier 6, and then I also set up our farming station here. The farming station, I'm using the solar panel 5s that we were using before, because these each produce 512 RF a tick. So we're getting 1024 here, and this thing only takes 600. So this is actually working pretty well up here. So let's go ahead and grab all of the output here. I've just been replacing this stone hoe that's in here, just over and over, which hasn't been too big of a deal. You can see I've got several made up in here. But yeah, so this is all tier 6 essence, which is fantastic. I'm going to basically continue to farm this, and as I see it fill up here or the hoe break or whatever, I'll just come and deal with that. But this has been really helpful to get that essence, having these all be tier 6. So yeah. So let's take a look out here. You can see I've moved all of my stuff, and it's all kind of tucked back away where it needs to be. I wanted to put the bed on the edge, but I was afraid I would spawn in these glass panes and then fall off the edge or something. So I just put the bed there, and then here's our AE system. Got everything in here, and then if we head down... oh, shoot. Check that out. All right, so our cleaver, we just got to... Wow, we have 7 modifiers available. That's pretty good. So we have this carbon cleaver. We're still using that. That's been pretty great. I also have this carbon pickaxe, which I've almost broken, so I need to be careful with that. But yeah, so down here we have this lava setup that we set up before. Now I've run power over to here. This goes up to those machines, and then we've got our AE system here. Now I left this gap here. I want to use a storage bus here, but I don't have the resources for that. And then I've moved all the different ore chunks and then their corresponding metals into each of these chests. And we have that on both sides here. And then we have a third side started over here. And so this is actually connected. I'm not actually going to do it, but underneath here, there's, I think they're called frames that basically connect these two sides together. So it's all one big inventory. So you can, well, like this, you can grab a bunch of different items and then you can just, double right click that guy and then you're clear. Cool. So it's been pretty great for that. And the next step here is for us to add a storage bus. So we'll get to that in just a second. I wanted to show you an upgrade that I made to the mob farm. Well, the fact that I have a mob farm really quickly. So we have this here, and I've actually shut it off. Oh, these dang Endermen, man. I've actually shut it off. For the time being, but I was just using this just to come in and punch them. It's worked out pretty well. I've gotten everything that I needed out of that. Now, I put this waterfall here. I can't remember, it was a couple episodes back I was talking about building a squid farm. This is basically how you do it. And if you notice, I have squid or ink sacs in my inventory. It's just because squids spawn in this and then they fall down. Something to note though, something that I found that was interesting, if we take one of these, I don't know. Oh, hang on. If you throw these in here, watch this. Oop, it didn't do it. There we go. Check that out. So that's part of the mod that makes the items do this, like, physical thing. It makes items float in water, apparently. I was reading some more info on the mod, and it does a bunch of other things as well. Let's go ahead and turn on our magnet, and then we'll go ahead and grab that ink sac as it goes up. Cool. But yeah, it does a bunch of other stuff as well. I don't know if you guys... I don't know if I recorded it, but in the Nether, if items fall into lava, they don't burn, and only the items that are like wood would burn in that. So items just have like sort of physical properties. And so I was kind of curious. I wanted to see, Obsidian, I would expect to be kind of heavy, or glass. I would expect those to sink, and then wood, I would expect to float. So I just wanted to test this out and see if that's actually the case. Because ink sacs were floating. Oh, we got another loot bag. That's another thing. The squid, when they fall, they actually drop loot bags, which is interesting. But let's go ahead and try out a couple of these different items here. I'm curious to know what floats. So I'd expect wood to float. And yeah, it looked like it was going to. I just need to get it in there, right? Yep. So wood will float. And what about glass? I would expect glass to sink. I can't tell. Yeah, so wood definitely floats. Glass sinks. Oh, that's so cool. That's so cool. And then loot bags, what do they do? Sink. Okay. So maybe items it doesn't really know what their physical properties are will always sink. But maybe there's just a few that it knows will float. That's really interesting. Anyway, I just thought I'd show you that. Thought it was neat. And yeah, so down here, I'm going to work on a better mob farm. I'm still trying to think up a design in my head. I've got a creative world where I built one that was pretty nice, but I still have a couple tweaks to make to it. So, whoop, scared me. Yeah, so we'll get to that eventually. Oh, is that wood block? Yeah, look, it's going all the way up. That's funny. Oh, I also, yeah, I added this platform here. This is about 20 blocks above here. Maybe it's a little more, maybe 24 blocks. Anyway, just so we could sit here in outside the spawn ring, or inside the spawn ring, however you want to say that, to where mobs will spawn down there. So this ends up being the perfect distance where they don't despawn, they only spawn. So let's head up, and do we get our wood back? I guess it doesn't matter, we don't really need it. Cool, so that's all those changes, and I feel like there was something else. Alright, I don't know what else there could be. So what we're going to get started on today, the first thing that I want to get done, is I want to get this interface between this drawer controller and our ME system, or AE system. So in order to do that, we actually already have an interface, and you need that combined with a sticky piston. So we actually have two regular pistons, but in order to make a sticky piston, I need slime balls. And actually, in order to make slime balls, the easiest way is to take this magma block. If we look at the uses on this, you can see you can use it in a pulverizer, and the pulverizer will turn it into 4 magma cream. Unfortunately, this only works in the pulverizer. It does not work in the sag mill, so I can't even put that item there. So we're going to go ahead and make a pulverizer really quickly. It should be relatively cheap. And then we'll go ahead and run this stuff through that. Oh, something else. Yeah, because all my metals are down here, I've actually got to come down here and grab all the metals that I'm going to probably need. So I'm just going to grab like a stack of each. And actually, we probably don't need hardly anything on this side, or anything at all, probably. So then let's head back up. All right, and there's our pulverizer. And then let's go ahead and grab our conduit as well. We have just this energy conduit. And we can go ahead and throw this guy. Actually, let's go ahead and use it downstairs, since we're not really going to be messing with it much. We can probably throw it. Yeah, we can do it there. Oops, not there. Oh, shoot. I'm getting real close on the durability on this thing. I got to be careful. Okay, so we'll throw that there. And then all we're going to do is just pulverize these magma blocks. And I really only need the one magma. So I'm going to grab just the one that comes out first, and then we'll go upstairs. Cool. So we just need the 4 magma cream. We only need one of them, really. So we'll grab our bucket. We'll fill the bucket with water. And then I believe you just craft them together like that. Yep. Slime ball. Perfect. And then we'll grab our slime ball, attach it to a piston. And uses. We'll go ahead and make this ME storage bus. Oh, that's a problem. What happened to my second piston? I thought I had 2. What the heck? That's so weird. You guys saw that I had 2, right? Am I crazy? Oh, I used it probably to make the pulverizer, didn't I? Yep. Great. All right, so we can now make that, because I made our second piston there. Limitless potential. Fantastic. And then if we go down here, we can go ahead and crouch right click, drop that there. And grab a cable. and drop that there. And then I should be able to, let's go ahead and double right click this to get all that stuff out of our inventory. And then how did I end up with a second tin gear? That's weird. Okay. We'll go ahead and throw all this in here. And as you can see, I have tons of cobblestone, gold, nickel, lead. And the nice thing is not only do I get the ingots, I also get the block version and the nugget version of each one. So all of these are going to be really easy to use for crafting, which is just fantastic. The only other thing that I want to do is I want to change the priority, and I want this to be lower, I think. Actually, I really need to Google that first. Okay, right. So they actually start at the highest priority. So what I'm going to do is actually set this guy to plus 100. That way, it's always going to try to go there first. And if there's no storage space there, it'll go to the disks. So that'll save us a ton of space over time and allow this to be a fully functional AE setup, which is just fantastic. I'm so happy. I'm so happy about all of that. And that means even if I come over here, I can grab this and all of this and drop it straight into our ME system, and I won't have to go downstairs to store all this. Awesome. That's so cool. And then if we go down here, we can probably see. Yep. Fantastic. That's so cool. All right. So we've got that set up, and oh, that's going to save us so much time. Let's go ahead and sleep really quickly, and then I'll tend my farm, and I'll be right back with you guys. All right, guys. Welcome back. So I've gone ahead and tended the farm. It's all ready to go now. So let's head downstairs, and I want to talk about this power setup that we've got here. So we've got 5 fluid tanks connected to 5 crucibles on top of 5 Eulorium blocks, and that's generating probably a crazy amount of power. But I skipped over this quest. I saw it, and I clicked on it, and I just completed it, but I didn't even think about what it actually meant. Faster crucible processing. And I thought it was asking us to make these items. I thought it was like, make 20 Eulorium blocks, and then make 40 Plutonium blocks. And no, actually, this is the speed increase that that these... Yeah, so if you look at the little pop-up on the top of the screen there, if we look at this guy, it says it's at 20 times rate. So if we look at that quest again, you can see Eulorium is 20 times, and that's actually the slowest of these items. Superheating element does 120, which means it's 5 times as fast as all... Well, let's see, we've got 4 of these. Oh, so I've got 4. Okay, I counted wrong. Anyway, if we come up here... I actually have, I believe, one of these. No, okay, I don't. In my single player, I do. But they are extremely cheap. Like, absurdly cheap. In fact, I have, I believe, all the items to make these. So I could just make one. But why? Why would I just make one? What I want to do, let's actually see how wide this area is. Because I want to go from block to block here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that's how many I want to make of this. So let's go ahead and head upstairs. Let's make 8 of this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right, so we need a little bit more steel. So I'll go ahead and make that really quick, and we'll be right back. That's interesting. So I have... What's going on here? Oh, shoot. I never... Are you kidding? I never connected the power to these guys. Let's grab... I don't want to use that pick. I don't want to use the rest of the durability on it, so let's grab a diamond pick for now. Yeah, I never connected these guys. I'm like, why isn't this guy running? That would be why. Cool. So we got that going, and I should be good to go. I think I need 7 of them, so I'm going to go ahead and wait for that. All right, that should be everything we need, so let's go ahead and do that. So that's going to be 6. 7... Oh, shoot. Okay. I'm bad at math. It's fine. And then 8. Cool. So we have 8 of those. And then what we're going to do is go ahead and craft 8 of these superheating elements. I just need copper for that. So that should be simple. So let's go ahead and throw these in here. And that should make 8 of those. Fantastic. Now, I know there's, I believe, one more block on top of that. Yeah, refined draconium block, which... is just not going to happen right now. So for now, what we're going to do is we're going to swap out all of the Yellorium for this superheating block. And we'll start actually over here. And I'm going to go ahead and move the power generation to this side anyway. So we're going to do 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then we'll just go ahead and grab that. And I know we're wasting lava, but at the rate that we're going to generate it, I don't think it matters. Let's actually grab... I'm just curious to see how long... That is one that's one bucket's worth of lava already. So that's fantastic. So basically, I'm going to go along here and grab all the rest of these. I probably want a crescent hammer. Cool. So we'll grab these. And then we'll move them over to here. And then we'll grab these. Throw them into the void. No, I'm just kidding. And then we'll go ahead and replace those with these. All right, so I probably am going to leave this cobblestone generator here. It may need to be upgraded to a tier 3 at some point, but I'm also going to go ahead and move all of the magmatic generators, and I'm thinking I don't even want the tanks here, to be honest. I think I want to switch this out for just a better way of retrieving the lava out of here. I think there's got to be a better way, right? So give me a little bit to figure out how I want to do that, and I'll be right back. Alright guys, welcome back. So I've decided that at least for now, I'm not going to worry about changing this. Eventually I will want to change the way that this is done, but for now this is going to work fine. So the only thing I need to do is to get the cobblestone generator hooked up. So let's go ahead and head up here and let's grab some item duct. And I believe I have enough to cover this whole space. Alright, that should be good. And then we'll go ahead and put the servo on here and then set this guy to... ignore redstone, and then I just want to see how long it takes for this. Oh, it may take just a little bit here. Oh, you know what? It's probably trying. Yeah, let's disconnect all of these. There we go. Yeah, it actually looks like the bottleneck here is the cobblestone generator, so we may want to upgrade this guy. I think we have a tier 3 already, but we could make a second one. Yeah, this is definitely not keeping up right now. Eventually, yeah, we'll be fine with this. It'll eventually fill up. Eventually, what I want to do is add speed upgrades as we need them. For now, this is more than adequate. This is just sort of future-proofing us. So we're pretty much stuck to this power generation for a while. We may come across a better way to do it, but for now, I don't think anything can beat this, especially at this 120 times. It's generating lava so quickly. That's fantastic. All right, so that is our power system upgraded, and we've got room for expansion this direction, and then we've also got room to add speed upgrades in here, so it'll be pretty great to have all of that. Now, I think the last thing that I want to get done today is I want to upgrade our mob farm. I want to actually finalize a design on that and build one so that we have a mob farm that we can use. So give me a little bit to get a few things together, and we'll be right back. All right, guys, welcome back. So I've decided, I think I know what we're going to do. Really quickly, I wanted to take a look at some of these unclaimed quests that we have, because I've done several things and I just haven't brought you guys in on them. So I've got the Cobalt and Ardite. That was easy. So we're going to claim that. And then we'll open all these as well. So I got the Tinker's Construct stuff. I did that a while back. Let's see. I did a ton of these ones for mystical agriculture. All right, so I did all those, and then I might have done a few others even. Yeah, I got a double layer capacitor because I created some capacitors for machines. I created this just to see what it was all about, see if I could put lava in it. You can't. Let's see. I don't know that I've done anything else. Oh yeah, check out. I've got all the solar panels as well. So one for each of those. And I've seen some people get some really good loot out of these loot chests, so it's important to claim these and not just forget about them. So let's take a look. Whoa, we got a ton of them. All right, so let's go ahead and open all these and see if we get anything good. Cryothium floor, I think we already had one of those. Cryostabilized flux duct, that's pretty good. Chance cube, nope. Growth crystal tier 3, no way. Fastest growth, works on a 9x9 farm, checks up to 10 blocks up or down, can be used as a water source. I don't know what that means about sponges. Let's Okay, before I open any more of these, let's go ahead and place this because I'm very curious to know what it does. So it's going to grab that guy. We'll grab this. Okay. We'll place this guy here and then fill that back in. And then let me just grab a hoe real quick. And then that seed we can just toss in here for now. That's fine. Cool. So I'll throw that away. Awesome. So I don't know how much of a difference that'll make, but that's pretty great. So I basically placed it where you would put a water source block. Even though this soil doesn't need water, you saw that I had the other one there as well. I'm not even going to put this one back. I'll just put this in here. And let's go ahead and continue opening these guys. That's actually pretty cool. I don't know if we'll actually see a big difference from that, though. All right, so we got another ring of experience. Enhanced energy conduit. Yellowrite ore. More yellowrite ore. More yellowrite ore. Guardian charm for all the guardians that are around here. Ectoplasm. Ectoplasm. 64k ME storage component. That's fantastic. Oh man, let's get on those right away. What is this ectoplasm used for? Okay, Spectre Anchor. I don't know what that does. Spectre Ingot. Spectre Key. Spectre Sword. Yeah, I don't know what all this stuff is. If that's any good, let me know. Otherwise, I'm just gonna hold on to it forever and never use it. What else did we get that I wanted to take a look at? I think that's it. I think we're good. I can't believe how many yellowrite ore we got in a row. That was crazy. All right, so let's go ahead and throw all this away, and then let's actually go ahead and make these into discs, because that's extremely valuable to have that extra storage there. So let's go ahead and make a couple more of these, and then a couple more of these. That's so cool. All right, so we've got four more 64K storages. Let's head down and go ahead and drop these guys in. So we've got tons of storage now. That's awesome. Oh, that's so cool. I'm glad that I opened all those up real quick. Okay, so the next thing that I want to get into is extra utilities too. I want to... Are you not harvesting? Oh, you've got no power. Yeah. Let's go ahead and sleep. I want to get into extra utilities too. It's got a lot of things that I want to use. One of the main ones being those speed upgrades for the generators. Well, obviously they work in other things as well, but these generators down here can produce a lot more power a lot more quickly if you have speed upgrades in there. So I want to get a few of those so we can get some very beefy power generation that hopefully will last us into the end game. Cool. So in order to get started with that, I need to make a few items. So I'm going to get those together and we'll be right back. All right, I'm actually looking at this, and one of the first things that we need to make is one of these resonating redstone crystals. Now, I'm almost positive. Yeah, we don't have any of those. We do have some of this redstone alloy, but in order to make these, you need redstone alloy, and then you also need an ender shard. That only makes one, so you need five redstone alloy per and an ender shard, which you can... Let's go ahead and make as many of these as we can. It looks like we'll be able to make eight for an ender pearl. Let's go ahead and make two of these. Let's go ahead and make one of those, and then two of these. One, two. Okay, so you can only stack up to eight. Maybe I want four. Let's do four of them. Why not? I've actually got the ender pearls right now, so let's go ahead and do that while we have them. And then this redstone alloy is relatively cheap, just redstone and silicon, so I'm going to go ahead and make a few of those. Wow. Okay, so I'm over here right now. I've only been over here for a minute or two, and this had fully grown and broken the hoe. So holy cow. Just since I placed that, which was maybe 2 minutes ago, this is how much Inferium Essence I've received. And in fact, it looks like it skipped a bit. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, so that's crazy. So this is definitely a big improvement on what we had before. That's fantastic. All right, so having that tier 3 is really great. Okay, so we've got some of this stuff. I think we've got enough to go ahead and get started here. So let's go ahead and take a look here. I want to make as many of these as possible. So I'm going to go ahead and throw the rest of this in here. And let's just shift click and see. Oh, that's interesting. There we go. Okay, so we made 8. Let's go ahead and make as many more as we can. 13. Okay, and then we'll throw the rest of these in here. That should be fine for now. If we need more than this, we can obviously do that. But let's go ahead and get the rest of this going. Oh, shoot. You know what? I'm completely out of redstone now. And that's going to be a major problem for this mod, because it's pretty redstone heavy, if I remember. All right, so we're going to get our manual mill here, which will produce our grid power as we need it. We also need a couple other things. All right, guys, welcome back. So one of the first items that we need to make is a resonator, which I have all the resources for. So we're going to go ahead and make that. And in here, we can turn polished stone into stone burnt, which is required for several different recipes. You can also create red coal, boost efficiency with additional GP up to 700%. Interesting. I've never seen that before. We can also make our upgrade parts. Let's see what else. Wireless RF heating coil. Use RF energy. Interesting. Yeah, there's a few things in here that I haven't seen before, so that's pretty neat. But basically, the only item we're really worried about right now is this stone burnt. You make it out of polished stone, which is just four stone bricks. So let's go ahead and make that. We only have 6 of this, so I'm going to go ahead and make a few more of these. And that means I'm going to need some stone. And to turn that into stone bricks. So let's go ahead and do 2 of those. And then we should be able to do 2 stacks of this. Cool. And I'll probably only run maybe a stack through right now. And in order to get this to run through, I basically just need to sit here and hold right click. Well, actually, I don't need to hold right click. I actually have no hands on the mouse. So at least I don't have to hold right click. But anyway, I'm going to go ahead and get a few of this together and we'll be right back. All right, guys, welcome back. So we have 6 of this stone burnt, which is all we need to make a water mill. So let's go ahead and make one of those. We need 2 more of these. Cool. And this will get us 8 GP in total. I can't remember exactly how much it actually is. Let's go ahead. I don't really have a good way to do this, so we're going to do it the sloppy way. All right, so what I'm going to do is just use this unfinished floor over here, and we're going to go ahead and place the water mill down. And then we're going to just do a diagonal. So we're going to probably start here in this corner. So let's go ahead and put it here. And then I'm going to put just some cobblestone around it. And I do plan to move this, but for now, this will just work for us. Let me just make sure I don't create any spawnable spaces. All right. And then for now, since we only have the one, I'm just going to fully enclose this. And then we should be able to grab some water from upstairs and go ahead and fill in the corners of that. I should only need to fill 2 diagonal corners like this. Okay, that should produce 16. Awesome. So that means that the rest of our stone burnt production will happen basically offline. We won't need to watch it. Cool. We won't need to hold right click. We could probably even speed this up by getting another resonator. Yeah, and they're cheap enough that I'm going to go ahead and do that. So we'll have 2 resonators going. Both doing stone burnt. Cool. And since they only take 8 apiece, we should have plenty to have them both running. And in fact, we probably could even get 3 in here because of the way that these... Oh, maybe not. Yeah, I think if you offset them just right, you might be able to get even 3 inside the loop there, but 2 is fine for now. So we'll go ahead and run these for a little bit. We'll get a bit more stone burnt, and then we'll get a few more of those water mills. All right, so let's go ahead. I think we can make a few more of these now. I'm not sure exactly how many more. Let's go ahead and put, all those in there. So we got 4 more. We can actually even make more than that, but for now, let's go ahead and get these guys set up. All right, guys, welcome back. So we've got these guys set up. We've got 5 in total and producing 80 grid power, I believe is what it's called. See ya, Hypno. And yeah, so that's just with 5 of them, and that's pretty good. So the next thing that we want to get into, and again, I will clean this up. I know this is hideous, and it's not going to stay there, trust me. The next thing that I want to start producing is the upgrades. So I'm going to go ahead and pull all of the resources out of here. We don't need those going anymore, and I don't even think we really need them for these upgrades. But let's go ahead and take a look. All right, so there's a speed upgrade. and increases the speed of operations, maximum upgrade 64, power penalty, level 1, plus 1 GP or dictionary. Yeah. Interestingly, there's two new speed upgrades, which I've never seen before. So, I don't know. Increases the speed of operations. It doesn't say how much better they are. Let's see what the recipe is. Magical apple. Interesting. Enchanted ingot. Block of enchanted wood. Enchanted ingot. Enchanter. Yeah, this is complicated. We're not going to go that far. Today, we're just going to do the upgrades. So we just need these base upgrades, which is just a bunch of gold. And the nice thing about this pack is, for whatever reason, it gives you a crazy amount of gold. So I'm going to go ahead and grab... one stack should be fine for now. We can go crazier in the future, but let's go ahead and put half in each of these to get those bases. And then if we look here, it's just a block of redstone and gold. And so the block of redstone is actually going to be the most expensive part. Redstone has been a struggle for me the entire time we've been playing. So it's something to maybe take a look at. Let's go ahead and grab it really quickly. If we look at the recipe for redstone, there's a lot of different ways you can do it, but the way that interests me is redstone essence. So that's basically magical crops or mystical agriculture. We're going to get into this in order to create some redstone. I'm done with the whole sifting for redstone thing. So this is probably one of the first resource crops that we're going to go for. And I don't know if we're going to do that today. I may do that off camera. I'm not 100% sure. But definitely we're going to go this way. And luckily, it's not that expensive. In fact, we could do it right now. Especially, man, I keep coming over here. This is crazy how much this thing is producing. Look at this. I'm going to go through that whole hoe right now. Whoa, that's weird. Do you see that? There's a block of redstone in there. Why is that? Do you see that? Am I crazy? That's weird. What? Okay. Those are slime blocks. It looks like. Okay. Maybe that's what they are. Anyway, look how much essence we have. It's ridiculous. So I think we could do that now. I'm not going to. I'm just saying I think we could. Anyway, let's go ahead and grab our little upgrade bases out of here. And then let's see, we just need the blocks of redstone, which actually, if I just throw redstone back in here, because we're using those compacting drawers, oops, we can go and just grab blocks out if we wanted. We can also just throw these upgrade bases in here and then just make these. So let's go ahead and make as many as we can. Four, 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 three. Okay. That's interesting. I wonder why. Do they not stack up to... Oh, they don't stack any higher than four. That's interesting. I've never seen that. But if we head down now, we should be able to throw these into here. And... Oh, that's weird. Okay, so this mod pack must make a change to these because it says that you can put up to 64 per block. But that's not the case. I'm only able to put four in. So this mod pack must change that and limit it to four per stack. I'm betting that's what's happening here. So that's interesting. I wonder if these other speed upgrades are also limited that way. Because if they're not, it's worth getting into those, I think. And then there's these. These are too high for us right now. But these, I think we could probably do. But yeah, that'll be nice to have these. Now, like I said, right now... Not an issue. We don't need power. But it's nice to know that once we need it, we can jump straight in and start getting the stuff that we need. It'll also be nice to start using the extra utilities pipes and stuff for transferring items and fluids and stuff. I don't plan to get into that right away, but it's always something that's on the table. So that's awesome to have that. Now, I was thinking that I wanted to do our mob farm today. Let's actually head down here and grab... I keep trying to remember to come down here to grab the ink sacks and stuff, but I keep forgetting. So anyway, we've got these ink sacks that are being produced, but I do want to work on the mob farm, but I'm just not sold on what we're trying to do yet. There's a couple things that I want to do, but I'm just not sold on how I want to set that all up. So I think I'm going to go ahead and save the mob farm upgrade for the next episode. And that unfortunately means that today's episode is over. But I do want to thank you guys for watching, and I hope you guys are enjoying this series. If you guys are enjoying it, please make sure you're leaving likes on the videos. And until next time, I will see you guys later.